Amazing Grace shall always be my song of praise.
Yes.
Yes. For he looked at us.
Yes.
And he bypassed all of our issues and situations and where we are.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus.
And he saw our need.
Yes.
God knew before we were even thought about that we would need a mother.
All right.
In his divine, infinite wisdom that in his plan that he had put together, saints, he knew that we would need a mother.
Amen. Right. Yes.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. When you look at the qualities of a mother, you will think about the qualities of Jesus. When you think of the character of a mother, you will think about the character of Jesus.
Yeah.
When you think about the love of a mother, you think about the love of Jesus.
All right, yes. All right.
When you think about the boldness of a mother, you think about the boldness of Jesus.
Yes, yes.
If you don't, I do. This morning I was reflecting on my mom. God gave me two mothers, and I said, God, you're so good.
Yes, yes.
Only you can do stuff like that. Amen.
Amen.
Because I heard people say, you only got one mom. Amen.
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 But saints, I came by here to tell you today, God is a type of God, praise God, that he can give you more than one mother.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Yes. Amen. Yes.
And I'm going to explain myself because I know some of you are medical people out there and scientists. You'll probably disagree with me, but see, each and every one of you are women are designed to be a mother.
All right.
There may come a time where you may not carry, you may not have, you may not birth a mother, but you still have the instinct of being a mother.
All right.
Yes,
all right.
Amen.
There are many women I know that never had. In fact, my great aunt, who adopted me when I was a child, she didn't have any children, but she was my mother.
Right.
Amen. Yes.
Because she treated me like her son.
Yeah.
She talked to me. She felt sorry for me when I was going through. She empowered me as well as encouraged me.
Yes.
I am who I am because of who she was to me.
Amen. Yes.
But
Amen.
Most of all, who I was to her.
Yes.
And then my mother, my birth mother, one, my maternal mother, she, praise God, I lost her in a car accident. Yes. My wife and I were stationed in England, and I got the call. I got the notice, but my first sergeant walked into my house, came in, and when he walked in the door, he said, I have something to say. And she'll tell you, I was on the steps. I said, my mother has passed. Didn't know why, didn't know what, didn't know how. But it's something about the separation of a mother.
Yes, yes, yes.
It's a detachment that you would never, ever, ever get over.
That's right.
Yeah, that's right.
Have you ever heard about twins? Ooh, you have a twin in California, a twin in New York, and one pricks his finger and the other one looks to see if there's blood. Why would we should get that pain? Our God is just that type of God. When he interwoven us together, that's what he do. That's what he does here in the body of Christ.
Yes.
When one hurt, we all should hurt.
Yes, amen.
When one rejoice, we all should rejoice.
Yes, amen.
This morning, though, I want to talk to you. I want to take you into, if you would, open up your Bible, praise God, and praise God, we'll go, hallelujah, to, I believe it's Titus chapter 2.
All right.
Verse 1 through 8. Get my glasses here, and then I'm going to let y'all out because I know you want to do something.
Can you see this?
Did I say Titus?
Yes.
Of a godly woman.
Amen. Amen.
Yes.
And the word of survivor. You do not have to stand. I'm just going to read and just follow with me. Is that okay?
Yes.
Okay. The word of God reads, chapter 2, starting verse 1. It said, but as for you, speak the things which are proper for sound doctrine. That the older men be sober, reverent, temperate, sound in faith, in love, in patience. The older woman, likewise, that they be reverent in behavior, not slanderers, not given too much wine, teachers of good things. Mm-hmm. That they admonish.
Amen.
The young woman to love their husbands, to love their children, mm-hmm. to be discreet, chaste, homemakers good, obedient to their own husbands. Obedient to their own husbands.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That the word of God may not be blasphemed. Likewise, exhort the young men to be sober-minded. In all things, showing yourself to be a pattern of good works. In doctrine, showing integrity, reverence, incorruptibility, sound speech that cannot be condemned, that one who is an opponent may be ashamed, having nothing evil to say of you. My brothers and sisters, these words are instructions to Titus as it applies, praise God, to the sound doctrine and teaching that he requires of the woman in the church.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You see, I don't know about you. I came more or less in my ministry, came up in the Church of God and Christ, and some of you, I'm sure pastors are familiar, and my wife are familiar, praise God, with, amen, the way back when a woman being on the pulpit was unheard of.
Mm-hmm.
A woman having something to say in the church while the church is going on was what? Unheard of.
Yes.
You come
Amen.
In, sit down, look you, be quiet, got anything to say, you wait till you get home. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
And discuss it with your husband.
That's right.
Yes.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
And you don't discuss it with him with an attitude. Amen. I know the young men say, where's that woman at? Amen. So as I get ready to start, I want you to focus, praise God, on the verses of 3 and 5, if you will highlight it in your Bible. Because it's something that you surely and truly should get back to. Giving honor to God, truly, truly giving honor to God, who's the head of my life, and to our wonderful pastors, Pastor Tony, Pastor Yazzie, Pastor Val, and all of their clergy and the deacons and deaconess. I'm going to get that spiel right on out the way. All your officials and all my wonderful brothers and sisters, God bless you, but most of all to the mothers of the church. If you are a mother in this church, you are the mothers of the church.
All right. Amen.
The same thing is required of the mother. It's the same required of the mothers.
All right.
Yeah.
Talk about
right.
Mm. Yeah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Sound doctrines are instructions from Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. Paul was a messenger, but they came from our Lord. And what we call it godly teaching. I don't know about you, but I find so many women now, they go around and they act like they don't have any godliness in them whatsoever.
Lord have mercy.
And then they cry and moan and complain about why they appear or they feel like they are powerless. Do you not know that you as a woman is one of the most powerful beings on this earth? Today, women hold the head position of most CEO companies. Yeah. Today, today, women in the other countries are the leaders of the country.
That's right.
Today,
right.
Tomorrow, we very well may see our first woman president.
That's yes, right. Ooh.
Right.
I'm trying to tell you that, but see, a lot of us think that the power that we can only acclaim as a woman is to get it by doing things that are ungodly. And it's not so.
Amen. Amen.
First of all, godly teaching is whatever comes from God. And God only speaks to us through the Bible. Come on, say
that's right.
Yeah. I hear people saying, God spoke to me and he told me about what you are supposed to do. Let me tell you something. When God speaks to you, he speaks to you about you.
Come on now. Yeah.
Because if you don't find out what he wants you to do, you can't tell nobody about what they should do.
That's right.
We as the people of God, men as well as women, we need to walk to walk before we can share the talk.
Hey, all right, my man.
Right. Okay.
Let us know that there is no word for the opposite of teaching. I looked it up. Pastor Val looked for the definition of all, and it said the definition of all is all. Mm-hmm. But when I looked up the definition of opposite of teaching, I found
it. Wow.
Because no matter which way you're teaching negative or you're teaching positive, you are still teaching.
Watch out there now.
All right. All right.
Jesus. That's serious. Right.
So, when you get up and gossip, all up and down the church and in your phones and all up and down the highways. Amen. When you're doing that is not positive teaching.
That's right.
Well, I'm the only one on the phone with the other person. The person you're talking to, you are supposed to be teaching them.
All right.
You see, older women in the church is not designed or distinguished or designated according to age.
That's right.
Older women in the church, according to the book, hallelujah, B-I-B-L-E, are the ones who have matured and have, hallelujah, and God has given them a position in the church to lead the people of God. You look around, your men are not taking their position as head of the household. And the Bible said if you can't take care of your house, paraphrase, surely you can't take care of the house of God.
All right. Amen. Amen.
Ever since I was young and high, women been running the church.
All right.
Right, sir.
I come from the Baptist church. They run it. Even in Kojic, they ran it. They just didn't run it from the pulpit.
All right.
Teach, Bishop.
There is no teaching if there is no learning. And there is no learning when there is no teaching.
My God.
You can't teach a thing if you don't know a thing.
All yes. Right. Amen.
Hello.
Amen.
I tell you all the time, read your Bible.
Yes.
I tell you all the time, mm-hmm. You have to get closer to Christ.
Yes.
You cannot take the word of Bishop.
That's right.
Yeah.
Without going and checking with God to see was Bishop in tune with you on that day.
Yes. Right. Amen. Right. Amen.
Oh yeah.
Amen.
Bishop can make some errors.
Right.
Yes.
Oh yeah. There's some time when Bishop is not where he's supposed to be, when he's supposed to be, and how he's supposed to be.
All right.
Yeah. I say yes. Yeah. Therefore, I repent.
All right.
Yes. Amen.
And so all of us are to teach.
Yes.
All of us are learning sound doctrine.
That's right.
For it's the instructions of Jesus Christ.
Thank you, Jesus.
Because if we don't teach,
thank you, Jesus,
then there will be no understanding.
Yes. Yes.
I don't know about you, but I remember when I could be in another room and my doors closed and my mama would say, what you doing in there, Ernest? And I said, nothing, Mom. And find out she already knew what I was doing. Amen.
Amen.
My mama had a set of rings on her right hand. I believe it was designed to keep me in order. Amen. And me, as young and immature and foolish and as crazy as I was, always stood on her right supposed to do.
All right.
Oh, I know God has something to do with that. Why? Because I thought I was a pretty smart kid. I thought I was sharp. But every time I did something wrong, it was time for me to be corrected. Seemed like I was on the right hand side of my mind.
All right.
And then here it comes.
Yeah.
Stop. Under the table.
Yeah. All right.
Out of the door.
Right.
And then with my high, I call it tenor, but then they call it soprano voice. When you heard that, you know you have been chastised by mom.
Right.
Another thing is that I remember when wasn't feeling well. I had a little problem at school, and the people were teasing me. And I'll tell you what it is. First lady don't know about this, but I told this little girl I was crazy about her. Man, I wrote a little note, said I love you to the depths of my heart. Didn't know what loving nobody with the depths of my heart meant. And she looked at me and said, "Well, cut your heart out." Saints, that hurt me.
Yes.
But also I was ashamed because I couldn't tell nobody else what happened.
Right.
But somehow mama just has a way of knowing.
Yes, she does.
She just knows. You think you're getting away with stuff. Mama knows.
Yes. Amen.
Let me tell you about mama. See, mama teaches from experience.
Oh, yeah.
You see, when you think you got away with something, mama done seen it done more than once.
Yes, amen.
And when you think you have created something to get to avoid mama and you know, to bamboozle her, mama already got something waiting for that. Amen.
Yeah.
Just like she take and make a cake, peach cobbler from scratch, she also taking care of you, raising you up from scratch.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
How do you find that out, Bishop? I found that out, Saint, that when I was, the mama would tell me, "Well, I want you back in here at 11 o'clock. But mom, Speedy mama don't make him come home at 11.
Right.
She said, "I ain't Speedy's mama."
That's right.
Yes, amen.
I want you here by 11.
Yeah.
You can't tell time.
That's what I mean by she operate by from scratch.
Yeah.
She don't imitate nobody else.
Right.
Come on.
Because her child is not like anybody else's child.
That's right. Amen.
You see, mama reminds me so much of the attributes of God that sometimes I want to ask mama, "Are you sure you ain't God?" And what I love about mama's real good God, and mama would tell you, said, "No, I ain't God, but I'm the closest thing to you."
That's right.
Well, how do you know that's a happening there, Bishop?
Right.
Because I don't know about your mama. My mama tell me, "Boy, I bought you in this world, and I can take you out."
Amen.
Does that sound like God to me?
Yeah.
So why do you think God speaks to older women first? Why do you think he speaks to them first?
Mm-hmm.
See, the church needs godly examples.
Yes.
The church, see, you heard the scripture that says, iron sharpens iron.
That's right.
Well, you can't sharpen nothing if you ain't been through nothing.
That's right.
Amen.
See, older women must learn based on verse 3. Verse 3 says, "Likewise, teach the older women to be reverent in the way they live." See, God requires your living to be godly.
Amen. Yes, amen.
I told you over and over again, you don't have a choice of being holy or not. God said, "Be ye holy, for I am holy."
Right. Yes. Right.
Amen.
Amen.
See, some people think that God gave me a choice to live holy or not. No, if you're not living holy, you are disobedient.
That's right.
Amen. Amen. Because God don't want you to teach those people that are in the church, who is the church, praise God, to teach them contrary of his teaching.
Yes.
He said, older women, ones that don't have to focus on on kids anymore. We're talking about the seasoned women in the church now, saints. I haven't gotten to the young women, because if the seasoned women in the church would get their act together, then I wouldn't have to talk to the younger women in the church.
Amen. Amen. Yes.
So don't get upset if I don't talk to the young women, but I'm talking to those of you who should have influence on the younger women.
Yes. Amen.
I tell you, I don't know about you, but I remember, praise God, I met Mother Pastor Simmons and Brother Simmons' mother last year. We was at here Mother's Day, amen. And she had such an aura. She had such. I didn't know her personally, but you automatically respected her for being a mother. There's one thing about a godly mother. You don't have to know her, but you will know of who she is.
Yes, amen.
You know who she represents.
Amen.
You know about it by the offspring. You know about the seed, her seed. You know how they come up and how they act and react. You know, even those who made some mistakes, you still know, because she has a brand on that child.
Right.
That child will bear the resemblance of that mother.
Yeah,
That's right.
She will.
Yeah.
She will. And I told you about the birth mother, but the same thing applies to those who are not mothers, who can have children.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Because God is a way, has a way that He can give you everything that you need to help someone whose mother did not follow His instruction.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah. Amen.
You see, the church needs godly examples.
Yes. Uh-huh.
See, God may be counting on you.
Yes, sir.
Mothers, God may be counting on you.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You may think you're slick now. But know this.
Yes.
If you think that you can get away with not doing what God wants you to do,
yeah.
I got news for you.
Yes.
Because God requires you to do what He wants you to do.
That's yes. right.
Because Amen. His requirement has a lot to do with your anointing.
Yes.
His requirement has a lot to do with how you should walk. Hallelujah.
Yes.
His anointing has a lot to do with how you should talk. Hallelujah. And here we go on. Praise God that a woman should be reverent in the way of life. The word reverent refers to sacred and godly. And so basically live life with God being present at all times.
Amen.
Mothers,
Amen.
Whatever we are doing, do it with God in mind. Hallelujah.
Yes. Amen.
My mom, she would get upset now when she would get upset about her friends. And I'm talking about my maternal mom now. She would get upset about people who would talk about her or treat her wrong or do something wrong. And I would say, I would really be upset. I said, Mama, what's wrong? How you? She said, I'm okay, baby. I'm okay. And she would always recite the golden rule. She said, do unto people as you will have them to do unto you. My mom was not one of those that finished the college or nothing, but she did have a love for Christ. She had a way, she had a laugh that would make you just, you know, just wake you up. And she had a way, and I remember hugging my mom before we went to England. I remember this hug was so special. She was working, and I went to her school where she was working, and I went in, and I told Mom, I'm ready, I'm getting ready to go, and she said, okay, baby. And then when I hugged, it was just something special about that hug. Mm-hmm. Don't take the mother's love for granted.
Amen. Yes, Amen. Yes.
If you want, I remember a young man came and hit me just as hard as he could. And then he said he hit me because he just didn't like me. But he messed up. He hit me in my yard and my mama was sitting on the porch. And when he hit me, I rolled over to one side and I looked with the eye that wasn't bruised. Amen? And guess what I saw? My mom was no longer on the porch.
Yeah.
Then I heard the noise. And when I heard the noise, I turned to where the noise was. My mom had this young man in one hand up in the air.
Yeah.
And they called me Junior Bugs. You hit my Junior Bugs. And I say that to give you this, that mamas are super.
Yes,
women.
They are.
Yes, they are.
Mama can do a whole lot of everything.
Yes, right. Amen.
See, Mama is not like the jack of all trades.
Right.
You see, the jack of all trades, Pastor Gavin, he can do a little, or she can do a little of everything.
Right.
But a mom,
Yes.
She can do a whole lot.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes, yes, God.
You see, mama can worry about you when you're out there in the street.
Yes.
And she do a whole lot of worry while you're in the street.
Yes, yes.
You see, mama, yeah, she's the one that can praise you even when you are doing everything wrong.
Amen.
But she can do a whole lot of praises.
Yes.
Not my baby.
Yes.
Not my girl.
Yes.
Not my daughter. Yes. That's mama. No one, mama, sometimes mama know that they're true.
Yes. Yes.
But mama believe that she can speak the truth and change the things that are not true.
Right? Yes, yes, yes.
Uh-huh. Because mama has a right hand with the God that we serve. Mom is a superwoman, y'all. Because she's superwoman, not because she has an S on her chest.
Right.
Mama is a superwoman because she is operating out of the supernatural.
Yes. Amen.
You see, the natural cannot compare with the supernatural.
Yes.
If you are close and close in contact with the Father, you can do things beyond your imagination.
Yes.
Why?
Yes.
Because unto Him who is able to do exceedingly and abundantly all that we can imagine. Give glory unto God.
Amen. Yes, amen, yes.
See, a mother is required to give God glory.
Yes.
In her walk, her talk. You see, one of the things I see here in 4 and 5, it says that a woman should not be slanderous. Because a slanderer is a person who false accuses. I hear conversations with women. I hear them at the workplace. I hear them here and there and everywhere else. And they talk, but their talk is not building up.
Yes.
Their talk is tearing down.
Yes, yes.
They talk when they talk about them negatively when they're feeling good.
Uh-huh.
And they talk about them even worse when they're feeling bad.
Uh-huh.
That's what I hear in the world today.
Well,
God does not want that type of woman in His church.
That's right.
Yes.
God does not want that type of woman to lead His people and His young women.
Yes. Yes.
You see, from this, I hear, I saw one of my cousins had put on Facebook, she was talking about her son, and she said, here is our future. Well, the Spirit put a check to me, and He said, no, He is not your future. He is your present.
Hallelujah. All right.
Because God requires you to make sure He grows up so that He can take care of your future.
Amen. 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 Yes.
The future He's carrying. He's carrying the seed that you were carrying when you were carrying Him.
Yeah. All right.
But He's no longer, He's not your future. He's your present. See, young people today, saints, are not our future. The young people of today are determined giving Hillary a run for her money.
That's right.
Y'all don't need that. And it's not the future that's giving Hillary a run for her money. It's the present.
That's right.
It's the young people that we are saying, that's our future president. It may be the future president, but he's not our future.
All right.
Amen. Yes.
As a Christian, a new creation for God. Always be intoxicated.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Now, we just read the scripture. It said, be not intoxicated with wine. Amen. But there are things that we are intoxicated with that God does not require also. Some of us are intoxicated with going to the beauty parlor every other week.
Amen.
Some of us are intoxicated about how men look at you and how he dressed you and all these big houses, and you ever see the women of reality shows or the women of this country and that state and that block, you know, always putting each other down.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Always putting each other down. Always looking for things, get me some false nails, false eyelashes, lashes, because that's what they like.
My God.
Mm-mm. Amen. You see, a mother, a superwoman mother, when I look at it and I think about it, I reflect on the fact she is not one that lap dances.
All right.
She's one that when she stands up, she can put you on her lap when you're hurting.
All right.
But when she stands up, there's no more lap.
Right, that's good.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Jesus.
Ah. Based on 4, and I'm going to cut you short, because let us include the call of older women to train young women.
Mm-hmm.
If you haven't caught on yet, Mothers are to train young women, right. Not put them down, not discourage them, not talk about them, mm-hmm. but to train them.
Yes.
We are to teach one another, and the core of the course, the best way to teach is to be an example.
Amen.
Mothers, let me give y'all an example of how you should be so that your daughters will know how to treat. Hallelujah, treat their husband, because it says, love your husband and your children.
Yeah.
It also says, be self-controlled and pure.
Right,
don't
right.
go haywire. Don't get up and want to, I'm going to kill him, and running into the kitchen and find all those things that makes you even more super powerful and you want to take somebody out with. No, 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 no. It said be self-controlled and pure. Be busy at home. Again, not busy bodies, but busy with a purpose for God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And then praise God, it said be kind. Be subject to their husbands, not malign the word of God. Malingering the word of God means that you are talking about a man of God, or someone, your sister, and you're talking about them in a false way. You're using word of evil thoughts against a person. You, as a woman of God, God says that should not be a part of your lifestyle.
Amen. Amen.
Wow, wow, wow. Well, this is a list of a superwoman, y'all. God is talking about here. But we must all work toward God's target for us. God understands our shortcomings. God loves, hallelujah, he loves it.
Yeah.
When we repent and call on Jesus,
yes.
We can do nothing without Jesus.
Amen.
Say amen,
church. Amen. Amen.
You know, I'm not getting ready to close. I just want to bring you to remember of those who are your scholars. Now, in the book of Ruth, we talk about a young lady by the name of Ruth. And right. She was with a lady, old lady by the name of Naomi.
Yeah.
Naomi was a Jewish woman who left her hometown, her home country, and went over to Moab. Hallelujah. That was not the place where the God's people lived. But she went there because there was a famine, hallelujah, right. in Jerusalem.
Right.
And so what she did was, when she went there, she had a husband, Elimelech, and then she had her sons. And so they found two young women to marry her sons. Well, her husband died, praise God, and then her two sons died.
Right.
So the daughter-in-law stuck with her. But then she heard that now that the land that she left years ago was now having plenty of food and they could go back home. So she decided to go back home. And I'm getting to the point I'm trying to make here, because when you do things and you teaching and you sharing things with young women, these women must become attached to you. They must want to serve your God.
Yeah.
They must want to serve God the way you serve God.
Yeah.
They must want to give glory unto God.
Right.
They must want to get up and worship him.
Right.
They must want to get up, hallelujah, and praise his name.
Yeah.
So Ruth, hallelujah, Ruth, praise God.